Last week, you may remember Flash Gordon and Del Arden saved Earth from destruction by shooting a rocket at a planet, which threatened to collide with it. They became marooned on the planet, called Mongo. The Emperor, Ming the Merciless, ordered Flash killed, and commanded Del to marry him. The Royal Princess, loving Flash, saved him. Thun, Prince of the Lion Men, helped Flash prevent Ming from marrying Del by breaking up the marriage ceremony and escaping underground. Now, we continue the story. Flash and Del are captured by the Shark Men. Princess Aura appears and again saves Flash, who in turn tries to free Del. But Thun's father, searching for his princely son, captures the princess and Flash. Rather than remain a captive, the proud Aura hurls herself over the cliff, only to be caught by the terrible leaves of a constrictor plant. Flash hastens to her aid.
Oh! Oh! Don't struggle, Princess Aura! I'll free you!
Oh, hurry! The leaves are crushing me!
I'll cut them with my sword!
Oh, be careful! Oh. Careful, Flash! The plant may touch you, too!
Ah! This devilish plant!
Oh!
Ah! Ah! There!
Oh, Flash! It's got you, too!
Yes! Yes, I didn't think it could! I think that's a tough break!
What shall we do now?
I don't know... yet.
Oh! Oh, Flash!
What is it, Princess? Are you in pain?
No, look! Look down there! Out there, a door in the ship has opened!
So it has! There are soldiers coming out! With strange-looking guns! Are those your father's men?
No! No, I've never seen them before! They must have seen us and come to take us as captives!
Well, at least they'll get us out of the clutches of this terrible plant!
Soldiers, attack that plant and kill it! But don't injure its victims. I want them brought to me alive.
Don't be afraid, Princess. Those men will catch you.
Oh!
Be ready to catch her, men. Now, the other one.
Here I come!
We're safe on ground, but what will happen now?
It's up to the leader of those soldiers.
Soldiers, you did that well. Princess Aura.
Yes, how do you know me? I don't know you.
I know your father.
Oh.
So what's this? Another white stranger?
Yes, Prince Baron.
Blindfold him and prepare our other white prisoner for the ordeal of the poison daggers.
As you command, Prince Baron.
What are you going to do with me?
Guard, take the princess to my quarters.
As you command, Prince Baron.
Ah, here comes our other white prisoner. Perhaps you know him, youth.
How can I tell? He's got a hood over his head. I can't see his face.
He says he's from Earth. I suppose you are from there too?
I am.
I don't believe you, but no matter. Our hiding place must remain a secret, so both of you must die. Are the white prisoners prepared, guard?
They are, Prince Baron. Their left forearms are tied together.
And the poison daggers, are they ready?
Yes, they are.
Now listen, prisoners. I am dipping these two daggers in dragon's blood. The slightest scratch from these blades means certain death. Guard, give these to the prisoners. On the count of three, you will commence fighting. One, two, three.
As Prince Baron utters the words, Flash steps back, jerking his mysterious antagonist off balance. He flings aside his dagger and then causes his opponent to drop his poisoned weapon. Picking up the dagger, Flash severs the cords binding him to his opponent. And as the two whip off their blindfolds and reveal themselves to each other.
Flash Gordon!
Dr. Zarkov!
So you do know each other.
I should say we do! I am mighty glad to see you, Doctor. I thought you were dead after our rocket crashed on this planet.
I was badly hurt, Flash. These fellows, they picked me up and brought me here. They made me act as their servant. Well, we saved the Earth, didn't we, lad?
We certainly did, Doctor. Now, Prince Baron, maybe you'll believe that we are from the Earth. This man was the most brilliant scientist in the world. He was...
Stop! My admiration for you is boundless. I would be honored to have you shake my hand and call me friend.
Your friend?
Yes.
Why, of course. Here is my hand.
And mine!
Good. Now come to my quarters, friends. I have invented an electric mole with which I intend to burrow underground into the palace of Ming the Merciless and overthrow his tyrannical government. Are you with me?
Certainly!
You bet we are! We've got to rescue Dale and Thun from that fiend!
Princess Aura, you heard what I planned to do.
Yes, please take me back to my father's palace with you.
You, why it is because of you that I am a hunted man with a price on my head. You will remain here as my prisoner. Come, my friends, come.
Oh, I will I? Guard!
What is it?
What is your name?
Ronko, my princess.
Ronko, I thought I recognized your face. You fled into exile from my father's guard when you were caught stealing.
Yes.
Listen, Ronko.
Princess?
If you would help me warn my father of what those men plan to do, I will make you not only wealthy, but also a duke.
For one so lovely as my princess, how can I refuse? Come with me.
Unaware of what happened in the hiding place, and racing underground toward the palace of Ming the Merciless and the terrible electric mole, Prince Baron, Dr. Zarkov, and Flash Gordon encounter a fierce Guaco, or armor-plated dragon. Flash climbs out of the mole and gives battle, saving his companions. For this, Prince Baron promises that if they succeed in overthrowing Ming, Flash will be made Prince of Mongo, and anything he desires will be his. Finally, the electric mole breaks through the floor of the central hall in Ming's palace. The door opens and the three emerge from the metal burrowing machine.
Come, my friends, we have arrived.
Ah, so we have. What is our next move, Prince Barin?
This is the central hall of Ming's palace. We will go up these stairs, Dr. Zarkov, and surprise the inner guard.
Prince Baron, look!
Ming's armored men!
We've been betrayed!
Yes.
But how could the news have reached here before us?
Let us get our ray gun! If we will die, we will all die for science!
It's no use, Doctor. The armor of those soldiers is ray-proof.
Here comes Ming the Merciless with his high priest.
No, Flash.
Dale! Thank the heavens she is all right!
Welcome back to my Paris, Flash Gordon. And welcome to your companions. Soldiers, rash them to the peers and re-execute them.
Oh, Flash, darling, I love you so much.
Dale, my dear, we did our best to save you, but we've been betrayed. I guess they have us now.
Let them shoot. They will kill me too, and then we'll be together forever.
Very well, dear Arden. You can have him in death. Captain?
Sire!
Proceed with the executions.
Shoot, you yellow dogs! We aren't afraid to die!
Ready! Aim!
Captain, hold your fire!
Zogi, what is this? If you were not the High Priest, I would have your tongue torn out for your insolence.
I ask you to remember, sire, that according to the writ of Pau, even a traitor has the right to choose between the firing squad and the terrible pit.
True, Zogi, and on second thought, such deaths would provide great amusement.
Yes, sire, we must abide by the sacred writs, and I see no reason why the girl should be killed.
Captain?
Sire!
Release the prisoners. They shall undergo the terrible test. Bring them over to the pit.
All right, come on, move along.
This is the test of the torture pit. Flash Gordon, you and Baron will stand at each end of the narrow platform and with long whips try to topple each other over into the pit where surprise will be waiting for you. Take your places.
The two mount the platform. Flash ducks as Baron's whip winds over his head. Flash's whip hits Baron with such force as to knock him off balance and into the pit. Dropping his whip, Flash leaps after him. As he throws the unconscious former Prince Baron over his shoulder and prepares to climb out, a transparent metal sheet slides over the top of the pit, trapping him. At the same time, Flash hears a growl, and looking around sees three snarling tigers. Placing Baron on the floor, Flash turns on the fierce beast. The first one charges. Leaping high in the air, Flash comes down on the tigern's back and with a powerful wrench, breaks its neck. The other two tigerns leap at each other to fight for possession of the body. Furiously, the battle rages. Finally, both animals are down, wounded unto death. Then Prince Baron regains consciousness.
Oh, where are we?
It's all right, Prince Baron. Stand up. We are in the pit, but they've trapped us with that transparent metal lid.
And you? You saved us from those beasts? Why, you are superb, Flash.
That was easier than figuring out how we are going to get out of here.
Look up there.
Prince Thun! He's just in time. Thun, roll that metal lid back. He nods that he understands.
There, he's done it. We're free.
Come along!
Meanwhile, in the Temple of Pau, Ming and Dale are about to be married by Zogi, the High Priest.
By now, dear Arden, my saber-toothed Tigrons have torn your hero to pieces.
Oh, poor Flash. He died trying to save me. Nothing matters now.
Here comes Zogi to perform a ceremony.
Oh, mighty Ming, ruler of Mongo and the universe, does your supreme intelligence take this Earthwoman to be your wife and Empress of Mongo?
I most certainly do.
And you, Dale Arden, do you take this just and brilliant man to be your lord and master?
I don't care what happens now.
As you have accepted each other in matrimony, before the great god Pau, I pronounce...
Wait! Stop!
The idol speaks!
I, Pau, forbid this marriage.
It's a trick! Furs! A stone eider cannot talk. Zogi, swing back the statue.
At once, sir.
Flash Gordon!
Flash, darling! They told me you were dead!
The Earthmen and two companions arrive.
Guards, shoot them down! The marriage must go on.
Wait, sire! The sacred writs say you cannot execute the man who has passed the test of the Tigrons. Guards, drop your weapons or Pau will curse you all.
What? You dare defy me?
I only quote the sacred writ, sire. As high priest, it is my duty to interpret and enforce its dictates.
Guards, give me your sword, Zogi, or I will shut your jabbering mouth forever.
Ah! Oh, how awful. He's killed a high priest.
Carry his body away, guards.
Oh, Flash, my darling, I thought I lost you.
Never. As long as I have strength in these two arms and a breath of life in my body.
So, Pau forbids me to slay you, huh? Well, Pau and I were both wrath while you and the rebels shrave away in the prison shitty of the Hawkman.
Death would be more desirable.
As for you, dear Arden, you shall be taught to act like my empress.
Doomed to a fate worse than death among the cruel Hawkmen, what terrifying adventures await our friends? Be sure to listen again next week for the further amazing adventures of Flash Gordon and Dale Arden.
Flash! Ah! Savior of the universe!